still on?
Okay, when using the CHAdeMO adapter, like so, you need to retrieve the charging handle from the station first. You don't want to do it after, because some of them charge by the minute. And then you'll connect it to the charging handle until it clicks. And then, you'll connect it to your car. And then it'll lock. So the next thing you want to do is authorize yourself with the station. You can do that with money or a card. Stand by while I retrieve my card from my pocket. There we go. So on these EVgo stations, you hit start, then you select CHAdeMO, which is either touchscreen or start again. And then you can give it a credit card or you can give it your EVgo card, which I will do by tapping the NFC against that. All right, it's seen it. So we push start to continue. It'll do a test, and then the car will test it, and then it will actually start. These things are loud, so you will hear it make a lot of fan noise. There's a contactor. Now it's testing. Fans kick on, and then you can see the Tesla is ready too. And so now we are DC fast charging. Okay, and we can see here that very much like the supercharger, or even our home chargers, you see some stats. So again, you don't really care about the miles per hour. You don't really care about the miles per hour because you can't compare that across cars. But what we can compare is the 95 amps at 387 volts. This won't be as fast as a supercharger, nor will the voltage and amps track the same way either, because this one has to match the voltage of your pack. So right now we're at 387, and that will go up to 400 and change, whatever the pack's voltage is. But the amps will start to drop as it reaches full. So the strategy with the superchargers is you want to charge often as you can, as low as you can. But with the DC fast chargers for the CHAdeMO, you actually want to do the opposite. You want to charge before you get to 50% if you can. That way you get more electricity per session. So let's look at the charge screen and see what we see. So we can see we've got 40 minutes till we reach the 90% set point. We're currently charging at 33 kilowatts. And remember that the slowest Tesla urban supercharger is 72 kilowatts. And the fastest current Tesla supercharger in the United States is 120 kilowatts. Some worldwide you can get to 135. Some in the States you can get to 135 too, but I have not seen proof of that, just I've seen the math where it does work. And then again, it'll show you how many miles on your charge it's added. So we've added 3 miles in the amount of time I've been making this video. And there you have it. That is DC fast charging with the CHAdeMO adapter. If they offer the combo plug CCS charger, I will purchase that and make a video on that for you guys as well. Okay, so to remove the CHAdeMO adapter, you have to have your car unlocked. Just like using the supercharger or your home charger, push the button and pull when it unlocks. Then you release the lock on the station, turn the handle, and your CHAdeMO adapter is ready to store again. The CHAdeMO adapter is an extra cost accessory that you can get from Tesla. I'll include a link and a picture of it in the video. It's not cheap. It's been on sale from anywhere from $300 to $500, and you can probably get a used one from some of the clubs for around $250 to full price, depending on who you buy it from. Ours took about 2 weeks from when we ordered it to show up at our house. But that's the CHAdeMO adapter. One end is CHAdeMO, one end is Tesla DC. And the reason I say Tesla DC is it's the thicker handle that you find on the supercharger. It's not the smaller handle you'll find on the home charging kits, or the one that comes in the car. So I just store mine back, and thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the flip side.